fans of the Horus Heresy, Legio Custodes, and doing impressions of Brian Blessed from 80s sci-fi pulp movies, thank you very much for joining me for an Out of the Pack review. And today's video is being made possible by a long-time subscriber and friend of the channel, Laurent Jaloux, who I've acquired some miniatures for, and he's asked if I could do an unboxing video, and that's exactly what we're going to do. And the miniatures in question, if you haven't already deduced it from my opener, is this Forge-walled squad set. And this is a Legio Custodes Venetari squad. So these guys are the most recent addition to the Custodians line for 30k, and they are in effect their jump infantry. So what this is a squad of three, I believe, full resin models. And what we're going to do is going to open up the pack. We're going to have a look at the miniatures, see what they're about, appraise the quality, and just generally, you know, have a little bit of a mosey. So that's what we're going to do. Before I get into this, I'd just like to say I hope you are all well, both yourselves, your friends, and your families, obviously at this extraordinary time that we live in, the worldwide coronavirus pandemic. So yes, I do hope that you are all keeping well. So without further ado, let's investigate further. So this is one of these newer, super compact little white boxes, quite neat. They're quite swishy, these. Certainly nicer than getting your miniatures in the old style boil in the bag. So, what do we get? We get a tray of parts, which, gosh, that's looks stuffed. And then we also have a set of instructions. And then the box. So we're not going to be needing the box for today's proceedings, so I shall set that to one side. There you go. It can loom in the background there. Right. So, tell you what, let's get that out of there so it's not so stuffed. This is the checking sheet or the packing sheet. This was kit was packed on the 14th of January by BMC. So, yeah, there we go. That's that little bit. Right. Instructions. Let's take a look at the instructions. So we've got a proper instruction set with this kit. That is nice. And on the front we have a picture of the assembled Venetari, resplendent in their lightweight custodian armor and flight pack type devices. We also have a nice little bit of fluff. So if you like the fluff, have a pause and have a read. So it's very kind of Mr. Jaloux to agree to loan these to me. And these aren't some miniatures I was planning on buying, so it's interesting to be able to make a video around them. Okay, let's see what we've got. Right, Legio Custodes Custodian Venetari A. Okay, so we've got an A, a B, and I presume a C. Yes, we do. So for this assembly, use all parts labeled A, and this is going to make one armed with the... We can do it with the Architect Kinetic Destroyer or the Venetari Lance. Okay, so quite a few parts to these, aren't there? Then for B, again you get the choice of the Lance or the Kinetic Destroyer. And then with the third one, again, we have the option, Lance or Kinetic Destroyer, and a Misericordia option. So those look like some pretty decent instructions to me. And then a full parts list on the back. Very good. As you can see, these are quite complex models. Each model has got 1, 2, 3, 4, about 18 parts or so. Maybe 20. I'll just do a very quick count. So yeah, quite swishy that. Good thing we get the instructions. So I'll put that there. Right, let's dive into the actual parts and take a look. So where should we stick this? Right, well, in no particular order, we'll start. I'm gonna put that there. And then in no particular order, we'll get the parts out and start looking at them. So what do we think? Very nice. Lots of detail, this sort of strappy detail. Only partially rigidly armoured legs. Imperial Eagle design there. The rest has got this cloth covering, which does make you wonder how that armour works, doesn't it? Got a mould, a slight bit of a slip to take away down there. It's not too bad. It'll take a bit of time to do, but that will clean up fine. That's that one. Right, what's this? This is the first torso. Ah, I've just remembered. I'm going to be able to use my favourite word. It's filigree time. So this is kind of like the armoured body and cowl. Yeah, look at the design on the jump pack. Yeah, very nice. A sort of eagle head to it as well. I do like that. That looks really cool. Seems nicely cast. A little bit of clean up here and there. It doesn't matter so much across the arm joints. That's fine. Yeah, looks good. All right. So I have another handful of parts here. So I have a couple of the spears to look at. So look at these things. I can't remember what the stats are on these weapon lines. I'm not very familiar with this squad. It's not something I've really looked into, in spite of the fact I do own a custodian unit. Well, I've bought the beginnings of my custodian army. It's just Forgeworld and never got around to releasing the Sisters of Silence, which is what most of it was supposed to be around. So, yeah, I hope they do that before I decide to sell it. Right, so what do we think? So I got some lots of nice detail on this filigree hand grips. Maybe some sort of power pack here or ammunition drum. Very good. Got a fair bit of cleanup to do with the mold displacement that runs along the edge of the detail. As you can see that there. And then also affecting it here. It'll clean up. It'll take a bit of time to do it though. You mean better not to have had that. Oops. Right, so next one. This has got a classic bit of Forgeworld warping. So a bit of, I think, holding this in a steam flow on a kettle that's boiling, that will easily straighten out. So, you know, bent parts don't matter. Warp parts are easy to fix. So same design as the other one. Got a bit of flashing cleanup to do around there. Part of the muzzle of this haft weapon is not quite come out right. I think probably what I would, I don't know, you could build that up and then rebore it, or you could just cut it down and bore it again. But yeah, that's not quite there, the end of that, the tip of that. And then there's a mold slip to remove here as well. Again, I think that will tidy up. There's a reasonable amount of work to do there though. Okay. Right. Pauldrons and, ooh, I can't remember what these are called now. It's been that long since I've done any armor reviews, but pauldrons mean filigree. And we have all the sort of custodian icons here. We've got thunderbolt flashes. We've got the double-headed eagle. Yes, and the actual filigree itself. They look nice. Yeah, really good. These will look amazing when they're painted up. Absolutely stunning. Another torso. I presume these torsos are all going to be the same size, so we'll just flick over and just check them for casting quality. That's nice, yeah, lovely. And the second set of legs. You got some lovely detailing on these lanyards here. There you go, got a nice crisp focus there from the camera. They're gonna look amazing when painting. We've got some nice motion into them as well. Very good. And likewise with the sashes. Tabard, I suppose. That's also very good. They're very dynamically positioned models, which obviously befits the fact they're flying. Now, this is a bit ugly. This is a proper old mold slip. That's going to take a fair amount of cleanup. Although it will clean up. I mean, one of the advantages with models that aren't sharp angles and armored surfaces is it's easier to deal with the mold displacements and slips. Obviously, it's always better. What you want is you don't want them in the first place because it takes time to put them right. Certainly, if you want your models to look seamline free when they're painted or finished, however you want to use them. But, cloth and fabric and flesh is obviously easier to get rid of those things than hard angles and mechanical surfaces. Right, we have the third lance. So same again, this is the best cast of the three. That looks good. Same design as the others, obviously different arm position. So one thing about this kit's immediate observation is you get weapon options for all three of the squad members. That is nice, I like that. Right, starting to, there you go, bodies, legs. Okay, third set of legs. Love the detail on the boots. Very cool. Got a similar thing with the other two. That the rear of the thigh got a mold slip that needs to be cleaned away. Not bad. And so far, all these castings have been they're nice and clean and dry. Although we've got some slipping, we do have clean casts, which is good. Right, we'll do the final torso, which is this. Yeah, that's fine, looks good. And then we will move on to, now we've done the torsos, let's follow into the flight bases. The flight bases. So we have this design, oh my. Now, these are fine from here all the way up to here and the attachment point. Nobody likes these attachment points. And yeah, it's just like, why Games Workshop? Why did you design them this way? And that, I think, is going to attach onto this little nubbin here. These are going to be interesting for whoever builds this to do, because I don't know if a super glue attachment between then and there is that strong. On plastic kits, these aren't so bad if you use plastic cement, that you can actually get a proper welded joint, although it's a pain to do. So I remember doing my Inceptors, my Primaris Inceptors. On this, I think it needs a pin, otherwise it's just not going to hold, it'll be too fragile. Superglue is quite a brittle adhesive, and on a small, smooth attachment point like that, I don't think you're going to get a good enough grab. So personally, I would put a short pin in using maybe sort of 0.3mm piano wire. So yes, we do get those. Then three standard round 40mm diameter bases. Good, right, have we done this? Yes, we've done this, haven't we? Right, what we've got next? Let's do some wings, because we can. So we get three sets of wings for the flight packs. I don't know what they're actually called. Let me see if I can look on the instructions. They are called left wing, right wing. I can't remember the rules on these. Like I said, I've not really read up on them that much because it's something that never really fit with the custodian army I was working on. Well, I did read them up on them when they came out. So what are these like? I think there's some cleanup to do around the base. Most of it seems to be flashing. There's a bit of slipping displacement there to deal with. I don't know if that is. I'm not sure if that is or if that's part of the detail. Overall, though, that looks good. Second set of wings. Now, I think it is detail, it's not slipping on the other one. These look similar to the first set. These are probably, I've got the same sort of slipping there. But that will, I mean, it just needs to sort of cut it up on each side. So that will clean up, so I guess that's fine. And the third and final set of wings. I've got an air bubble to fill there. Some cleanup again to do around there. Another small air bubble to fill there. You could easily fill that with some super glue. Yeah, nice. Lovely designs, aren't they? Got these kind of these curved engines. And perhaps this, which is maybe a cooling vent, a little bit of filigree, and then these quite delicate looking wings. Well, not that delicate, actually, quite formidable looking wings, actually. Right, what's next? What's next? So we have this. This is the front part of the torsos. They look good. Similar to the plastic custodian models we all know well. All the same design, no differences in design as we did see on some of the plastic custodians, if I remember right. That kit's amazing. I think the plastic custodian kit's incredible. So much detail and variety in that. You can tell that they put a huge effort into that one. Right, more pauldrons. So here you've got the large ornate bas-relief eagle. Early Imperium unification war style. They look very nice. A little bit of flash to clean up, but very nicely cast. Very good. Put those there. Oops, keep everything in camera shot if I can. And then these. So these are like the buckler shields, which I think they go hand in hand with the Archaeotech pistol variant. That's right, yeah, you've got buckler and pistol or lance. So fascinating design, very ornate and curvy. These things look like they're both a weapon and a buckler, a small shield in one. I'm not sure what these count as. I don't know if they're combat shields or something else. Knowing the custodians are probably something unique and specific to them. Interesting, there's only two of those. The reason why there's only two is because the third one is here, along with another two tabards. Look at the detail on that. Very, very nice detail. Yeah. So much going on here. A lot of flash to clean up. The casting looks good overall. Tiny little air bubble. Just in there, you may not even, I can even get focus on that. I definitely saw one there. It's very small. You could probably just cut that away, actually. Good. So that's all the bucklers and the tabards. And we're moving into the late stages of this review. And now we have a set of three Misericordia. The Misericordia look to be exactly the same design as those on the plastic custodians. I say they look to be, I'm not 100% sure. Interesting point, they feature the what looks to be a precursor badge to the Crux Terminatus. On the cross guard. That's cool, that. And the thigh armor as well. I think are all the thigh armors the same design? Oh no, you see those are different. So two the same, well. Oh no, they're all different. Maybe they have been consistent with the plastic custodians and I was wrong before. Maybe it's a thigh armor that was different on all the plastic ones and the torsos were the same. I'm still not 100% sure on that, but with the thigh armor, they're all different. Right, then we have these things, which I really don't know what those are. They are number three. vent covers. So it's something to do with the jetpack. Oh, there you go. Ah, so that, as I said, that cooling vent. So I guess you can stick those these guys on. So the vents are either closed or open. Well, that's nice. I think that'll look rather cool, that, and lend additional dynamicism to the model. Very good. And nearly finished now. We have some arms. So I don't know if these are... Now, let me think. These... I don't know if these go with the spears or the bucklers or what have you. I think maybe the part multi-use. Anyway, are they cast nicely? That's what we're really thinking of. Do they look good? Well, they certainly look good. Yeah. No, I'm very nice at cast. Lovely. Guns and ammo. These look awesome, these are. These are called the Archaeotech Kinetic Destroyers, and it's like an Archaeotech pistol, so you strength 6 AP3, but I know they can shoot faster. And they're like these really ornate revolver-type weapons. Lovely. And that sort of harks back to that well-known Praetor Space Marine miniature, which has an Archaeotech pistol revolver. That's a really cool miniature as well, and these are a similar design. Yeah, they look good. Got a bit of cleanup to do on all these, it seems. Yeah, got more cleanup to do on these. On the sort of arm bit. On the couple, but the pistols are nicely lined up, it would appear. Yeah. Good. Very nice. Lovely dry casting again. And then the final thing, and perhaps not accidentally, I've left the heads until last. So what do we have for the heads? Well, we actually have some nice head styles for the three Venetari. They have similar gear, but we have one with a Mohican or a Mohawk. Probably a Mohawk. We have another guy with some nice slick backed hair. So this guy's, he's clearly got his Dapper Dan on there. You'd definitely have your Dapper Dan on if you're going to be going into combat, flying into combat. And then we've got this dark guy who's gone smooth up top, Horus style. Oops, we shouldn't compare the Custodians to the War Master, should we? Or should we? But yeah, really cool faces, three different designs. Well, faces, heads. I like those, they're good. And that brings me to the end of this review. I think there you go. Almost didn't get everything in shot there. There we have now. There you go. So the Legio Custodes Custodian Venetari squad from Forgeall. What do I think? Well, I think they're beautiful miniatures. Very dynamic. Loads and loads of detail, as you would expect from these. I mean, I actually think these look incredible. There's so much to get going on with these. In terms of conversion potential, I think there's something you can do with the arms. Legs, less so. But you could probably, I mean, for three like this, it wouldn't matter. But you could heat these legs up and bend them into slightly different poses quite easily. Not a huge amount of maneuvering there, but it could be done. I imagine these models could be combined with the plastic custodian kits and even the 40k ones to create some interesting conversions. In terms of the kit quality, overall, I'd say this is good. All the parts are very cleanly cast, that's nice. Most of them are properly lined up. I think the only things where there's more work than I would like to see is on these legs. And I think most of all the spears, some of the spears are going to take quite a lot of work. But overall, it's all going to clean up well and it'll look fantastic when done. I hope you found that an interesting unboxing review. Please do share your comments and observations, as always, about these miniatures in the comment section, and indeed any comments you have on the rules. Once again, I'd like to thank Laurent Gelou for arranging for this to happen, shall we say. Thank you very much, sir. That's everything I have to say for this video. I do hope you all stay safe. Hobby on. Great time to hobby at the moment, isn't it? Fantastic. What a great hobby we have for this moment in time. But other than that, I'd just like to say thank you very much for watching. I'll speak to you next time. And goodbye.
Oh, well. Who wants to live forever?